Welcome to another episode of Good Libations, which is our show about mixology. And because we are still in the middle, sort of a pandemic, I'm going to emphasize the use of the mask, but not constantly, but whenever you need it. Because there are going to be times when we should be wearing it. And again, this is just to emphasize the necessity of it. Now, we're going to go on to the actual mixology. And in this particular episode of our show, we're going to feature drinks. Every single drink is actually going to involve the use of dry ice. And I'm not going to actually use dry ice because there are certain precautions that you have to use if you're going to use dry ice. You're going to have to use something, a heavy glove to pick it up because it will burn you. It will give you frostbite if you're not careful. You have to remove it from a drink that you've put it in. You just want it to get super cold and you want the display of the nice seeming smoke coming up from it, which is actually just vapor or gas. Because dry ice, being carbon dioxide, goes from a solid state into a gaseous state immediately. It's what they call sublimation. So the effect that it produces is very, very nice. It's kind of like the use of liquid nitrogen, which we've done before with nitrogen-infused drinks. It has the same effect, but it's not quite as lethal, but it'll make a drink super cold, and it will create quite an interesting look to the drink. But today we're going to use cachaça, my favorite Brazilian spirit, and we're going to make a couple of drinks from Brazil with cachaça. And then we're going to switch and make another drink that is actually an ode, if you could believe it, to Star Trek. But anyway, we're going to add cachaça, first of all, to the shaker. And then we're going to add a bit of elderflower liqueur to make this drink. And this particular drink is called the Niterói, which is a city in Brazil, that's fairly close to Rio de Janeiro. Then we're going to add a splash of passion fruit sparkling water. And then we're going to cut into a kiwi and muddle the kiwi in the drink, which adds a nice touch. And this kiwi is really, really ripe, which is what we want. We want it to be really mushy and ripe, so that we can muddle it up really, really well in this drink. And in addition to that, we are going to add a bit of grenadine and lemon. So I'm going to add the lemon first. And I'm using a makeshift cutting board, which is proof to you that you can improvise anytime you have to. So we're going to add the lemon at this point here. And normally what we would have done is put a small capsule or chunk of dry ice in the bottom of the shaker, but we're not, like I said, going to actually use that. We're just going to allude to it so you'll know that that's what you want to do. Then we're going to add some key lime to the drink. And then we're going to add regular ice. But keep in mind, we normally would be using dry ice, and then we would have to remove it before we serve it in order to get that smoky effect. So I'm going to go ahead and also add a bit of grenadine here to give it color. And then I'm going to shake it up good. And again, keep in mind that if you use actual dry ice, you're going to have to wear gloves to handle it, not imbibe it or swallow it in any way. Remove it from the drink after we get the special effect from it and the coldness. But in the meantime, we're going to shake this up carefully, and we're going to dispense it into this type of a glass, basically what we would call a margarita glass. And again, cachaça has such a wonderful, unique flavor. It tastes a little bit like tequila, and oddly, a little bit like Scotch whiskey. Go explain that one. And we'll put in a bit of lime, and we'll put in a bit of lemon to give it that nice effect. And then we're gonna taste it to see if it lives up to the hype. So I'm gonna do that right now. Oh, that is very good. Very good. And cachaça is perfect for summer. It's the idyllic summer spirit and summer drink. So keep that in mind when you decide to make cocktails to use cachaça in the summer, because people love it. It's unique, it's really good, and adds a nice flourish and touch to everything, and it goes with anything. Barbecues, spicy food, you name it. That is ever so nice. And I'm gonna have to dry off the counter here because I've gotten it a bit soggy. So keep in mind, if you're gonna make this cocktail, you're gonna use cachaça, you're gonna use elderflower water, you're gonna use grenadine, and you're going to use fresh lime, fresh lemon, and muddled kiwi, which I very stupidly neglected to do in the shaker. Let me go back to that step. And this is proof that, you know, we're gonna make mistakes sometimes, and don't feel that it's the end of the world and it can't be rectified. So I'm going ahead and muddling the kiwi, and then I'm going to re-dispense the cocktail. Yeah, because the kiwi is part of the flavor, so it's important that we have it in there. And again, a nice soft kiwi is what you want. And I think perhaps even putting the kiwi in the drink might be nice. Adds a nice touch to it too. So I'm gonna take another taste of it again, just to make sure it's okay. Oh yeah, that is very good. Very satisfying and tasty. So again, we wanna make our cocktail out of cachaça. And again, whenever we drink, we want to make sure that we drink responsibly and carefully, because we want to keep our community safe and well spoken of. And thank you for tuning into another episode of Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews, and thank you very much again. Bye-bye.